Welcome to another Moment in Time with Taylor. I am here today with my friend Dinesh. His hashtag,
guys.
His username is in the title, at PerryMonkey1. Give me 1 second to just load my egg drop here so we can keep track of all of our lovely comments. All right, and then I am actually gonna show you guys exactly, why is it freaking out? I don't know why it's doing that. All right, let's try a little refresh.
It's fine. That looks kind of,
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, it's better now.
Cool. I'm afraid to click this, but there we go. Awesome. Hello, everyone. Hey, Michael. Hey, Tracy. Hey, Tamisha. Great. Let me show you guys exactly how to do this. All right. Can everybody hear me okay? Fancy. Yes, I definitely have to give Dinesh a lot of credit because he taught me how to do a lot of this. Yes, awesome. All right. So you can see the screen of my phone here, and I'm going to show you how you get into the settings to actually go into Periscope Producer, because that'll be your first step. So if you click Periscope, and go into the little group of humans there. Let me use my mouse so you can see it. And then your personal information. Scroll down to your settings. And once you're in here, you're gonna scroll down and you'll see Periscope Producer right there. So that's the first step into using that. You're gonna wanna click in there. And then you'll see where you can put in all of your different encoders and all of your different settings, which you can learn all about from, hello Milzawar, from this handy dandy guide, which is, I think 5 pages long, is that what it says? Yeah, I think it's just about 5 pages long. It's a Dropbox link that I can send to you guys. So if you want a link to this actual guide, step by step, exactly how to set everything up, it's really, really easy to go through step by step, because you can't really watch a broadcast and do it unless you have 2 phones. So rather than take you exactly step by step like a tutorial, which Dinesh, I believe, does do, and I definitely want everyone to make sure that you follow him at PerryMonkey1, that you can just kind of get a link to this and go through it yourself. So if you want that, DM me at FemYogaTaylor on Twitter. And then I can also send you a link to this video, which is a video of someone taking you through it step by step. So that can, you know, depending on if you want to read it or listen to it and, you know, be able to pause it, you know, however works best for you. I used the video, but whatever's easier for you works for me. You start Periscope. You started doing broadcasts? Hey, Cyanide, hello! Cyanide and Tracy, I feel like you guys are my besties. Okay, all right, got distracted. All right, what are you up to, Dinesh? What's going on here?
I'm watching the broadcast on my phone. So, as well, reading the comments. So.
The audio is coming through a little robotic. Is it sounding like that on your end when you're hearing it?
No, actually, it is. Yeah, it sounds good actually. I don't hear any robotic from my side.
Okay, well that's cool. Then maybe it's just echoing back on my side. So it looks like egg drop's not loading here. So I'm just gonna jump in here. So when you're using Periscope Producer, and I'm just gonna give like a brief intro as to what's going on here, and then Dinesh can take over and say everything he wants to say. Is you have to download this program called OBS. So that is what I'm in here, and that's where I have everything set up that I'm using to do this broadcast right now. Now right here is what I'm going to work on, which is highlighted down here in my sources. It's a browser source. I'm going to double click it, and I'm just going to click OK to refresh it. And then what should happen eventually, if some people send me some hearts, I can send myself hearts, is we should start seeing some hearts pop up here. There's a little bit of a delay, but hopefully this will work, and if not, I don't know. I failed. I don't see them coming up, but it does usually work. I can kind of tinker with that if Dinesh, if you want to kind of take over and tell us some of the stuff that we have going
Yes.
on here.
Yeah, so pretty much on OBS Studio. So like right now, I'm seeing your screen like OBS. So you have, as you can tell, as you can see, there's like different sources. So we're using, I mean, just in general, like you can add video capture that Taylor is on, and there's Windows capture. So you can have different sources in OBS. You can add video, pictures, almost everything. So pretty much Periscope Producer is just broadcasting from your computer. So if you would like to, you know, show something creative, like if you like have some artistic, or you know, if you want to show your business website or anything, like so you can use Periscope Producer, you know, broadcasting from your computer, things, you know, like what we're doing. You can have like a split screen broadcast. You can have like you know, it's like a live you know, like live conference, pretty much kind of what we're doing on Periscope. And yeah, you can do almost everything on here. It's very easy to use. Yeah, so this is the website that you can download OBS Studio for free. I think yeah, you can just go on there and download it for free. And also, you can check my Periscope as well, and YouTube channel, Periscope Producer. So I have like tutorial videos on my YouTube channel. My YouTube channel is Periscope Monkey, which is saying, is it screen sharing?
Sorry, yeah, so what I have here going on in the sources is called display capture. So you're actually seeing my whole computer screen as I kind of like fuss with things and get distracted by other things going on, like comments, which I want to say it's not 1 a.m. here to name same, and I want to say hi to Trevor. And what, you know, what I could do here, we have a Google Hangout going on, is I could share my screen to Dinesh, but not, you know, basically what I'm doing is sharing my screen through OBS. So it's called display capture, not actually screen share, but yes, it's pretty much the exact same thing. And then I just have that kind of shrunken down. Let me just stop tinkering with that. That's this red rectangle right here. That's my display. So I could have the whole, that blown up to be the whole thing, so you could just see that in the broadcast, or I can kind of have these separate sources like you see here. I'm trying to get something fancy going on here on the side. We'll see if I can pull it off. So I'm going to refresh EggDrop now that I read some comments. And yeah, everyone, take this opportunity. Make sure you add Dinesh. Actually, Dinesh, you're in the broadcast. Do you want to throw up some emojis so people, you know, they'll see you more easily? Oh, there we go. That should work better now. I'm excited, guys. I feel like this is gonna work. It's gonna work. Go. Wait, what am I doing?
This. So there's the monkeys emojis. That's me right there.
Yes, monkeys. Oh, where are my hearts, guys? Why? Oh, is it because I don't have any? Somebody send some hearts. I'm testing hearts. I don't think it's working. How can
so,
I?
So also, I think. Like you can also like if you want to go more advanced, like, you know, if you want to have like a real high quality studio, and you know, you have your own production, like you want to do your own production, you know, you can you know, you can buy a green screen. You can have a green screen background, and then you can have like virtual backgrounds, like let's say you want to have like a newsroom, like, you know, you want a newsroom, you can have a virtual background, and you can get these online, like a virtual background. And once you get a green screen, there's an effect, it's called Chrome Key on OBS Studio, and you can find this on my Periscope and also on my YouTube channel. So I have a video on how to use Chrome Key with OBS Studio. So
awesome. On your YouTube
yeah,
channel?
You can, yeah, I have, well, actually, I made a tutorial. I have a tutorial based on that, like how to, so you can add, like, you know, virtual backgrounds, pretty much, with your green screen. And you can get, so I think, is there a way to broadcast from your laptop camera? Yeah, I think that is what, Taylor, you're using your laptop camera, right?
Yeah, that's what I'm actually using here, so I'm just gonna leave it like it was, but that's what this video capture device is. Actually, Dinesh just taught me how to use it. So if you want to add a new source, you just hit this little plus sign down here on the bottom. Hit plus, and this is how you can experiment. We were experimenting for like a half hour before we went live, and you can do all the experimenting you want. There's a lot of things you can do. A lot of people use this for broadcasting gaming. So if you do gaming and you want to live stream that, you can put that up on your Periscope using Producer, or you can use OBS with other platforms as well, but obviously we're talking about Producer today. Hey, Al, and hey, anybody that I didn't see. Hey, other name, same, Taylor. Who else is in here?
And also, and also, like, on Producer, if you're using multiple cameras, like, you know, you want, you can, on Producer, you can, like, switch angles, like, switch cameras. Like, if you want, like, one side, like, you know, the different angles. So there's a, I mean, on, there's a feature on that where, you know, you can switch angles for your cameras. Producer.
Is there, are you set up to show us how to do stuff on your screen, or?
Let me see.
Yeah, I know, it's like, let's prepare first. So does anyone have any questions, anything they've tried using with this that hasn't been working? Al, I'm wondering, did you get EggDrop working for you? Were you able to get your comments and everything coming in? Oh, what is that? Not sure. yes, awesome. Do you love EggDrop? I love EggDrop. If you don't love EggDrop, don't answer the question. Could one person
okay, so I have a question about EggDrop. So because I have free account on EggDrop, so I think you need to have a premium account, right, to really do this moderation, and then, you know, to I guess if you want to download your broadcast, you know, all those cool things, so you have to have a premium account for that.
Yeah, you can get premium, but when I was first starting out with broadcasting, honestly, the free account was really, really awesome still, even though it wasn't you know, anything premium about it. I didn't have, like, all the extra features, like what Dinesh was just talking about, which is basically, like, if we had someone come in right now and say something really offensive, he and I was talking to you guys, I wasn't paying attention, I missed the comment. Either he or Al or Tracy in the room right now, any one of them could block that person on my behalf because I have EggDrop Premium. So that doesn't work for everybody, but that's not necessarily something you really need until you have tons of views on your broadcast and you're getting tons of people that you're trying to block at once.
So I think external or internal mic is best for broadcasting. I think, well, we're using built-in, I don't know, are you using built-in microphone, Taylor, or are you using?
Yeah, I'm wondering how the audio is, like, I can try to listen to it on my phone, but it might feed back a little bit, but it's, like, a really crummy, I feel like it's not a high-quality microphone built into my Sony.
No, the audio is good, actually, I mean, I'm just listening right now, like, there's a bit delay, but the audio quality is good, so... I don't think
I hear the crunching, like I hear that, like,
oh,
robotic.
Okay.
Oh yeah, Al, that happened to me before. Oh yeah, that's a great question, Al, thank you so much for asking that. Yes, yeah, it's crunchy, yeah, it is crunchy. I don't know why it's like that, but it wasn't like that before we went live, so I think it has something to do with, like, I don't know why that would be happening.
Is my sound not clear?
Yeah, your sound's like really robotic and crunchy. But it wasn't before we went live. It sounded fine. You sounded fine. So I don't know.
Maybe something with the with connection for Periscope. So when, because you know we're doing like we're using Periscope Producer. So whenever we're, you know, there's encoding, so it takes bitrate for audio. So sometimes, you know, it can go smooth, it can go so it depends, like, on the connection.
Yeah, this crunchiness that's happening must have something to do with the connection, because I almost wonder if we, no, it would be too much, yeah, it would be, I don't know, what if you try, like, turning your mic off on Google Hangouts and then back on again or something, like, I don't know if it's probably, It's probably online. Yeah, so the microphone situation, I personally
I think
have.
you're right. I think you're right, Taylor. Because you're using microphone in OBS, right? And you're using microphone on Google Hangout.
Yeah.
But yeah, if maybe I don't. I mean, if we tried, if you mute my. There should be only external sound from OBS. That's what I'm assuming.
Okay, try saying something now.
So, on your OBS,
To
right, you
know.
have microphones. So, if you mute that, then you have speakers where we're speaking.
Yeah, I tried both. It didn't make any difference,
Okay,
but
maybe it's the connection. Something's wrong with the.
yeah, something. So we're sorry for the crunchy audio, but hopefully you can still kind of figure out what we're saying here. We're gonna always be improving. This is our first one done together. We're both
Yeah, this is the
excited.
first. Yeah, we've done
Yeah, it's fun. So we're just having some fun with it, and we're gonna get, you're gonna see our evolution as we get better and better as we go. So, what I wanted to answer Al's question is this right here is probably your problem, your desktop audio. Make sure you have that muted. I just basically tested this out with a friend, and and that fixed the problem like instantly. I just turned off desktop audio, and I wasn't getting the feedback and the echo anymore. So try that and let me know if it works. Any other questions about anything that anyone has in particular? Otherwise, personally, I'd like to hear about what is the first step. Oh, wait.
person switch between mutes while broadcasting.
Yes, I know that you can do. So let me just plug Vanessa and Joey because they're so awesome. Yes, Al, yes, turn off desktop audio. So Joey is the creator of Egg Drop, and Vanessa is his wife, and they're both awesome. And she hosts trivia often on his Egg Drop account, which is EGGDRP. That's the account that they do their trivia on, and she uses OBS for it, and she does some really cool stuff. She switches the screen, you know what I mean? She looks up a picture and has the answer, and she hides the answer, and then she shows that. So I know you can switch around with screens. Dinesh, can you tell us at all how to do that? Because I personally don't know how to do it, but I know you can do it.
So, switching screens. So you're talking about so if you asked multiple sources, so you have one screen for Egg Drop, you have one more screen for you want to show a video, or so you can pretty much. I don't like I can see the screen with OBS, but what you can do is on this the tab.
That's how you do it. You click
Yeah,
the
so you click
eyeball.
on the eye, you just click on
Yay!
the eye thing, and then it mutes it closes that screen.
Victory is ours.
Is Egg Drop only for Periscope, or is it for other apps?
Egg Drop is only for Periscope right now. Yeah, it's just for, and it's only for Periscope broadcasters. It's not useful for if you don't broadcast. Unless you want to use it for direct messaging and you don't want to use any other social media, you can do direct messaging on Egg Drop as well. And I don't think that's just a premium feature, although I'm
Yeah,
not sure.
and also Egg Drop, you don't need to use Producer to use Egg Drop. Egg Drop, you can just do it from your computer. But if you want to, display on the broadcast, you can use this Periscope Producer to display Egg Drop.
Right, yeah, you don't have to. Egg Drop's really not part of this whole thing. I just usually use it to put up the hearts, but it didn't work. So now it's just a little black screen. Hi, Brennan. And thank you for sharing that out. The people who just shared it, I appreciate that. What's going on here? I'm here. Dinesh is here, and we're teaching everyone how to use OBS and Periscope Producer for their broadcast. So if you want to show stuff on your screen or share YouTube videos or you know what I mean, you can show people how to navigate your website or show here. I can kind of.
Is there a request for it to use for Facebook Live or YouTube streaming?
I
Is there a
think
request?
a big.
No, well, for YouTube streaming and Facebook Live, you don't need to really request because there's already for YouTube live streaming, you just it, the encoder. So pretty, there's details for that. So they already have custom RTFE. That's what they use for Periscope. So if you on your YouTube channel, like if you want to go live, they have the RTMP, the server, so you don't need to request really for live streaming on YouTube. And also with Facebook Live, you don't need to request. They already have it. I think if you're like, Facebook page, if you want to go live on Facebook page, you can, there's an option to go live. And I think it's better, like, if I sh I don't know if I can show it, or maybe sometime, we'll probably do a specific tutorial for that. I think we should do that, Taylor. Like,
Yeah.
maybe some, maybe how to go live on like YouTube, and then maybe how to go live on Facebook, something like that. Maybe upcoming tutorials, we can do something like that. What do you say?
Yeah, I definitely. I'm always down for doing more collabs. And I one thing someone had a dream about me. I want to know what that was about. And, the last question. I invited you to a yoga class and you couldn't find it. That's so funny. What sounds good to you, Tracy? Which part? Oh, how come I can't click on comments? But you know what? That's what egg drop is useful for. So I think the question was, can you use egg drop for, is there a demand for using egg drop on any other tools? And I personally, not that I know of, because there are a lot of things that Periscope doesn't have that egg drop supplements that is very specific to Periscope, like the disappearing comments. So that doesn't on Facebook and on well, not on Instagram. On Instagram Live, while you're live, you can scroll back through them. So there's not so much of a demand for egg drop. Maybe actually, maybe more on Instagram Live than anything, because Instagram Live immediately deletes your lives right afterwards. I haven't personally talked to Joey about that, but I definitely want to give you Vanessa's username before I forgot as well. I'm like trying to keep all these things in my head. And her username is Bane JS1. I'm just gonna type it in. That's
How
her
do you do
username.
Instagram Live? I feel, well, Instagram Live, I mean, I used it before. So if you have Instagram app, I think you have Instagram, right, Taylor?
Yeah, I have
Or,
Instagram. Yep, same username, Femi Yoga Taylor.
okay, because maybe if you want to show through your app, how to go live,
Yeah, I can do
if you
that
want to
right
go live.
now. Yeah, we can go live on Instagram right now because I won't. The thing with Instagram is the discoverability is the lowest I've ever seen. Like, I
Yeah,
get
that's the,
maybe 5 views the whole time I'm live, and very minimal engagement. And they immediately delete afterwards. So even if you like the broadcast, you can't keep it. So personally, that's my least favorite one. But I can show you how to go live because it's pretty cool. And certain phones are actually too old to do it. Like I have an old Samsung 3 or something, and a Galaxy 3, and it doesn't work. But I also want to first answer Al's question here. He asked, "How can we get rid of all the bad broadcasts?" And I don't know what you mean by that. The bad broadcasts. What do you mean by that? Do you mean like inappropriate, like nudity? Because I see that pretty rarely. I just block anyone I see who shares it or posts it usually. And then. Maybe a speed set so
Something,
comment will scroll slower. Set the time for scrolling.
Taylor, you know something? I hear your computer sound from here.
Yeah, you hear the fan, right?
Yeah,
Yeah, and
I
that was the
think
question earlier that I wanted to talk about was that I do have an external microphone, but when I plug it in, it doesn't pick up on OBS. So if you want to teach me how
okay.
to do that, that would be awesome. So let's just go live on Instagram really quick. So let's go back to this
This is if you
thing.
see me.
Sex activity. Oh, hi, Christopher. Welcome. Hey, thanks for inviting your followers, Trevor. I keep forgetting you guys can see me because, like, I can't really see myself on my screen. But anyway, okay.
So like we're now like switching from Periscope producer to Instagram Live. So just you guys feel free to ask any questions now.
Yes.
I think
Well,
so.
really quickly, well, I want to say hi to Slim, and I also wanted to say thank you for inviting your followers. But also, I am going not to be able to see the comments right now because I'm going to go to my homepage and go on to Instagram. So just know that I'm not going to see your comments momentarily. But you can talk to Dinesh because he's in the room. Dinesh, why don't you throw up some more emojis so everybody can follow you and
Yeah,
chat with
let
you?
me do that. So yeah, guys, if you have questions like with Periscope producer or Facebook Live or just about any social media like live streaming, you can follow my Periscope, and also you can follow my Twitter PerryMonkey1, which is my new. On there, you can ask me questions. If yeah, you can ask me questions there, and also my YouTube channel is there, but I'm still working on that. So I just have Periscope tutorials on that. I don't have any tutorials with Facebook Live or other platforms. But yeah, I mean, we will do this. I think Taylor and we will plan on doing different segments. Maybe if you guys want us to if you want us to have talk about Facebook Live, how to use this software to go on Facebook Live or YouTube Live. YouTube Live is like the next demand, Facebook Live and YouTube Live.
Yeah, so someone asked how to go out live on Instagram, and I can't see any comments, so I'm gonna quickly get through this so I can get back to the next thing.
Oh
So
yeah,
when
I
you're
probably
on
should keep up with the comments since you're going live on Instagram.
so here you can see you're at your first page when you first log into Instagram. I'm gonna swipe my finger to the right. Actually, I can use my mouse so you can see it. I'm gonna click and drag. Maybe. Oh, it might freak out because of my camera. I'm not sure. It's like stuck.
Oh
Okay,
yeah,
there we
you're
go.
using
There.
camera, right? So yeah, it's better. Just maybe if you just show them how to go live better.
Okay. So then if you click live, or wait, click it or scroll to it. Yes, just tap it, and then it'll say start live video, and that's how you go live. So let's go live for like 5 seconds. Checking connection. Check your hair. Oh, it's looking a little frizzy. It's still a little wet. Didn't have enough time to dry it. I am now live. Hello, Instagram. And the thing with Instagram is that you don't talk to replay viewers because there's no replays. It automatically deletes, so you just sit here and it's just a waste of
Just wait for
content.
someone else to come watch your work and stuff.
Exactly. And literally, I mean, we could, I mean, I'm kind of curious. Here, I can read the comments on EggDrop, but like, no one will come into this broadcast. You can see this. I will prove it to you. And I can read your comments right
No one
here.
says,
Oh, wait.
geez, you are going live on all social medias.
Oh no! What's happening? Okay, I lost it. Oh, I'm still live on Instagram. Oh, that's cool. So if you accidentally, oh look, it's Trevor.
Hey, my
Yes.
followers joined me as well.
Yes, I'm going live on all social
Just
media.
about.
So the only person that came into my Instagram already left, and it was somebody from our Periscope page. So, but that's pretty funny, and he's back. But I'm gonna go off of this because we kind of, I think that proved the point. So I'm gonna end that. If it had been a Periscope broadcast, we probably already would have had like 5 people in here. So I think I ended it, but I'm not really sure. End live video. One viewer. What?
Probably it's really, good starting. I recently had a lot of engagement, and we had a lot of people actually in this broadcast, which is really nice. And I think that's what it's good to have Periscope in some way, because if you guys have questions, you can ask us. Because there's those who want to know how to use Periscope Producer and how to go reach out, to someone, especially. If you contact Periscope or if you contact anyone. So that's what we would like to do on here. We would like, we want to give you that live, just interaction and help on how to do this.
Hi, Cyanide, how are you? I missed a
Oh,
lot of
yeah.
comments, but I'm glad it said Cyanide is actually the Heart Master. I saw someone get called the Heart Master, but it's actually Cyanide. Well, actually, oh my God, who was it that beat you? Why can I not think right now? Oh no, Cyanide, tell me who outhearted you. You're Ducky? Well, that's good. Look at my hair. It's like a big dreadlock. Casper, yes, it was Casper. Too nice. Too nice 420. Now everyone has to follow him because I totally forgot who it was. TOONYCE 420. It feels cool to be a viewer on my own scope, and that's what it's like on Periscope Producer. So you do use your phone to kind of view your broadcast, but you can set your phone up to be used as your camera. I haven't mastered figuring out how to use it as my microphone yet when I use Producer, but I have at least figured out some pieces of that. So you can use it like that.
Yeah, I can use it, but that's fine.
Hi, Believe. How are you? Sorry. Isn't it really
late?
That
was some really good questions that, you know, you guys asked, actually. Some really good questions. Because I think that's what we're really looking for. I mean, that's what Taylor's also like. You know, that's the purpose of this broadcast, actually. Like, you know, to what you guys, you know, about Periscope, Producer, YouTube Live, Instagram Live, you know, there's all of these live streaming platforms that, you know, just really demand.
Yeah, hi Chad. Hello, hello everyone joining us. It is cool, right, Slim? You should start using it. It's pretty dope. It's
You guys should use it. I mean, it's a different, especially with Periscope. Like, you know, if you do all this, if you're really, like, you know, into business, and if you want to promote yourself or promote your business, Periscope is really Periscope Producer is very useful, actually. There's many brands that are using Periscope Producer now. I think you've probably seen, like, you know, most of the brands, like, you know, like, I saw a few, like, Nike, I saw a few, like, you know, like, Coke, and, you know, all these brands that they're using Periscope Producer, actually.
Oh, I didn't even see that yet. That's really cool.
Yeah, Periscope has their own brands now. They're using, you know, Periscope Producer pretty much to, you know, to promote. I mean, obviously, advertised, you know. So
cheers.
So it's a really good demand, you know, especially if you have your own brand or business that you would like to, you know, promote.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah. Okay. So I want to definitely promote Periscope in general right now, just doing broadcasts, even if you don't use Producer, because it's a lot easier than to just broadcast without Producer. It's the best way to get discoverability. So whether it's your art, your music, your talent, your ideas, your thoughts, maybe you're lonely and you just want to talk to people, whatever it is. I mean, if it's your business and product, your service, I do love water. But Periscope is the best discoverability I've ever seen. And I've tried Instagram, YouTube, and Facebook Live. And I've done live.me as well. And nothing compares to Periscope, in my opinion.
Yeah, I think that's what my, I say that I think my favorite live streaming app with, you know, social live streaming app, I would say Periscope compared to, like, you know, others, like Instagram Live. Even YouTube Live is, it's kind of hard to get engagement and viewers if you really have, like, you know, good content or you're sharing something, you know, like tips, like what we're doing right now. But I would say Periscope app is probably the best to,
it is,
you know, to do,
it's the easiest to go live. Yeah.
And engagement.
Yeah, and it's like you just get the app and then you go live. It's like everything else added live in, you know, after. So it's an add-on to, like, their messaging and posts and photos and albums and all this different stuff. So it's just very clean and basic and straightforward, and it's kind of a nice supplement. It's interesting, too. It gets me using Twitter a lot more than I ever used to. I don't know if anyone else in the chat is in that same boat, but I, like, never use Twitter, and then now that I use Periscope, I use Twitter.
Yeah, actually, like, I used Twitter yesterday. I used Twitter Live for this account, and to be honest, like, I felt really, like, different. I mean, it's, like, different experience, because you're used to, like, Periscope app, and then you see, like, all these people, like, you know, you get views and engagement, but Twitter Live is also good.
What live?
Exactly, soon all these social medias will be same. Yeah, kind of, it will be same, pretty much.
Yeah, hopefully they'll just pick whatever works best for each of them. So, and the thing was, so I made the switch, why am I holding this? So I made the switch from basically Facebook to Twitter, because now I basically never use Facebook, and I feel like there's kind of an anti-Facebook sentiment around a lot of the people that I follow on Periscope. I don't know if anyone else has noticed that themselves. Thank you for
inviting me. I think for me, Facebook is personal in a way, because I don't like to, like, do live streaming on Facebook, because it's like, You have your, you know, like friends, families, and someone, you know, who will be watching Facebook Live, and pretty much you don't want to, like, you know, bother them, you know, with your feed, you know, about live your Facebook Live.
Gonna
But if
have
you have a
to.
Facebook page, then that's good. Like, you know, if you have like a business Facebook page or any kinds.
Yeah, so I was gonna say, I would have to, like, you know, I think friends and family are some of the best sources of income for your business in a lot of cases, and that they can always turn notifications off if they don't want to know what you're up to, I think. Because I think you should go live everywhere, and for me personally, because my yoga business is a local business, it seems like it'd be more profitable to go live there. But once I started using Periscope, I mean, I had a loyal, regular following, people who come to my morning show every morning, and they just love it. Yeah, Facebook's just not as cool as Periscope. It just doesn't get you that organic reach, you know, that big, big, big reach. My first ever Periscope broadcast, I had 446 live viewers.
Actually, to be, I used to do Skype broadcast using Periscope producer. I guess how many views I would have just starting off like that. I had over 1,000 views. I'm not joking. I had total, I mean, total of 1,000 views. I'm not trying to, because it's really, in a way, like it's good. I'm talking about Periscope producer, not like Periscope app. So when I use Periscope producer for Skype broadcast, I mean like Skype calls, you know, like what we're doing right now. It's like a split screen Skype calls, and I had, I mean, on my previous account, you know, a lot of engagement. So it's good to use this platform, Periscope app especially.
Yeah, I agree. Actually, why don't I leave that up because we're kind of talking about OBS anyway. Ooh, I was gonna say something, but I totally forgot. I'm sorry. Maybe looking at the comment. Oh, I do want to point out a new feature on Eggdrop just because I forgot what I was gonna say, which is that my super fans' comments are now colored. They're now blue. So you can see Chad is a super fan, so his comment is in blue, and Cyanide, blue. So it kind of stands out as you're scrolling through. If you have a ton of comments coming in, you can kind of like make sure that you're getting your most loyal fan base and checking that out. And I think that is for all users. I don't think that's just premium, but again, I'm not positive on that either. And just in case you guys just got here, I just quickly want to say, DM me, direct message me on Twitter at FemYogaTaylor if you want the links to the Dropbox for the Periscope Producer Guide and the link to the video that tells you exactly how to use Periscope Producer. And this tells you, both of them really tell you exactly how to set up all of your settings. And it takes, I mean, honestly, I would, oh, that's what I was gonna ask you. I was gonna ask you, what's the most views that you've ever had on one broadcast on Periscope?
Yeah, I told you. I mean, but using Periscope Producer or just not Periscope Producer?
Oh, both. Yeah, in general, whichever one is higher, whatever you're higher in.
Yeah, I had, I mean, I told you, right? I think the most I had was over 1,000 views total, because by using Periscope Producer to do Skype broadcast, I think many people were interested to see, like, and I think it depends on the time as well. Like, I used to do that, like, during weekend, like morning around lunch, after lunchtime, I used to start this Skype broadcast thing. So I had over 1,000 total viewers, which is really cool, actually. I don't know where the statistics are coming, but I think there's a diff when you're using Periscope Producer, you get statistics from everywhere, like not just Periscope app. You get from Twitter, you get from, you know, like all kinds of search engines. So it's you know, like. But most of it comes from social media, Twitter and Periscope app.
That's really
So I
cool.
had over, yeah, 1,000 viewers for those Skype talks.
Right, and there's the potential for so much more. I mean, the most I've had on one was one of my late night salad scopes. For any of you who've been following me long enough to know, when I did the 30-day salad a day challenge, and I had over 30,000 live views on that one broadcast. And I was being promoted on a Periscope channel, on a featured channel that day. So there's a lot of different ways you can do that. So if you're trying to grow your Periscope following, definitely reach out to me, DM me, even if you're not interested in using Producer and you just want to grow your following. And I love, you know, helping people do that. And one thing that I'll say, just like an easy free tip, is move around. don't just sit there and be perfectly still and talk, because people, it's like it doesn't catch their eye in their replay, in their lobby. Like, if in the, like, if I'm like, or something, like, just do something weird, or, like, I've seen people just, like, go, like, really close to their eye or something, like, and just, like, stare at people until they come in or something, like, but, I mean, obviously it's best to have good content, but you'll see, like, the top influencers, I'm sorry, I've totally been not paying attention to comments, but they always, I don't know if you know Tai Lopez, but it's, like, when they talk on their phones, like, they're either walking around or they're, like, they're moving, and they're always, like, they're talking and they're doing this, and it just gets you better engagement. It keeps people around longer. I just put my phone in my purse. I'm sorry, guys. I brought you back out. I hope you're okay. So energy, you know, you want to have movement energy, definitely. That'll get people, you know, it makes people, you want people to feel better after they watch your broadcast, not any worse, not any more like meh than they already did. But if you, I mean, you can also reach out to this community too. I mean, I have a friend on here who, she would just start with, you can sit still if you tried. That's good. That's a sign of health, I would say. She just started doing dark scope. So she would, if you don't know what a dark scope is, it's when you just cover up your camera so that you can't, nobody can see anything but black on your screen. And
when I started Periscope, I used to do dark scopes. I was, I used to do it sometimes, but not anymore much, no.
Yeah, so she would just do these dark scopes, and she would be, like, crying, basically, just really kind of upset. And she would be, I don't know, she was having suicidal thoughts, she was just feeling really depressed, and she would just go on Periscope and be like, I feel really crappy, I just want people to be nice to me, just say nice things to me, or something like that, like, just talk to me, like, I feel very alone. And she said she got the most amazing, most loving kind of family, like, community on here. And now, I mean, she always does scopes. I don't necessarily want to say who it is, because she shares her story on her scopes all the time, but you'll have to see her when she's here on her scopes at some point. Or, I mean,
I think I'll email you, maybe.
Yeah, yeah. And she's so awesome. She's just, like, all of her scopes are about positivity and energy and changing the world, and it's just, like, you know what I mean? You just never know. So even if you're in that place and...
Taylor, I think, I have, like, my laptop is not charged, so I have only 12 minutes of laptop charge.
Okay. All right, well, we can end this. Does anyone have any last questions before our batteries die?
Yeah, before our batteries die.
Me too, Tracy, and you're a big part of that circle of love. I feel like I have such an awesome community. I love all the people on here. You're good? Awesome. Everybody do broadcasts now that we're done. Do your own broadcast. Teach us some stuff. You don't have to use Periscope Producer. You can just dance around or tell us about your life. People like to hear about it. Oh, you're welcome.
Yeah, like, I used to do, before Periscope Producer sometimes, I think, I used to do dance schools just for fun. I used to do cooking, traveling. I mean, mix up everything, you know. I just try to mix it everything so that I don't do same thing, because it's not good to do same thing. And, you know, you want to switch it around sometimes, once in a while.
What's a good dance song? We should do a dance right before the end.
My battery's going to run out, Taylor.
It's going to run out? You said you had 12 minutes.
Well, now it says, yeah,
12 minutes. 12 minutes, exactly. Don't, come on, you know you want to dance, Dinesh. Come on. Don't be like a Periscope egg and stay inside your shell. What's a good one, you guys?
But next time we'll try it. I think the next time is moving slow now, so next time we'll do it, okay?
All right, fine. We'll have to find a better song, because I don't like any of the songs that I see. Fine, you're off the hook, Dinesh. One last time, anyone who just got here, let me know if you want me to inbox you, or DM me on Twitter if you want me to send you the link to the guide and the video on how to use Periscope Producer. I hope y'all have a wonderful day. All right,
yeah,
have a good day.
So thanks, Taylor, for bringing me here in your school. I mean, I'm sure we're going to do some more later on, but thanks to your followers and, you know, for, asking questions. So it was good interacting with all of you guys, and so I hope you guys, you know, reach out to my Periscope and, you know, my social media if you guys have questions. So thanks for watching, guys.
Yes, everybody follow Perry Monk. Monkey One. He's in the chat. I don't know if he can send any emojis. Everything's dying.
Yeah,
but
I can
oh, you caught the end. Hello, D. Hello, Pilowan. I'm sorry you guys just got here, but we have to go. Batteries are dying, so we will do it again. Make sure you follow him. He's right there. Hey, Dylan. We're just ending this scope, so catch the replay. And thank you guys all for being here and sharing this out and being awesome and sending hearts. We're almost at 2 million hearts. I bet we'll definitely be at 2 million hearts before the end of the week. So. All right, I'm going to let you go, Dinesh. Thank you so much for being here. Everyone follow PerryMonkey1. This has been another Moment in Time with Taylor. I hope you all have a wonderful rest of your day, and I will see you tomorrow morning at 8:30 a.m. New York time for the Femme Yoga Morning Show.
Wait, yep, thanks for watching, guys. See you soon. Thank you.
And a random countdown for the delay. And that seems good.